Okay, so here we go. Good evening, everybody. This is session 150815, the free DM 101 class. We're running a little bit late, but hopefully you hung out. Had a little bit of technical difficulties. Our streaming computer is AWOL right now, so we're using a secondary system. So hopefully this will be okay. I think, though, from what I see, Chris, it looks like your system might be stuck on frame 45. Is that what's happening there?
No, it says 1 minute 20.
Okay.
It's been counting.
No, it looks like it's going now. Okay. So, anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and throw these things up. Like I said, I think I put the cart before the horse last week. I talked about how to DM. On Roll20, you know, quick and dirty. You don't have to do any graphic arts work. Just, you know, I showed you how to do all that. You can go and check out the handout in the DM 101 forum. Tonight, though, I'm going to talk about how to make a group, how to build your group. And I don't have a whole lot of stuff written down. I just have a bunch of handouts. So I'm going to show you this one. Show to players, show to everybody. Take a look at that. Okay. This is what you see on the DM side when you start up Roll20. Okay, so if you look like slap bang in the middle of it, the light blue thing, it says looking for players active. I clicked it and then a drop down shows up. It says manage listing. All right, so when you click that manage listing, it takes you to another area, and this is what you see. I have it in two parts. This is at the top of it. So if you click on the icon, it'll zoom in. This is on the top part, and then as soon as we're done looking at this one, I'll show you the bottom part. Okay. Let's take a look at a couple things here really quickly. The left-hand side shows your listing status. Okay. If you don't have it set up right, it'll say it's not shown. And it'll say this listing is not being shown to players because of whatever, blah, blah, blah. So what we do is we go in there and we set it up, and then your group will show up in the Roll20 search function. So anyways, let's take a look on the right-hand side. You select all the things that it pertains to, whether you're playing D&D or Roll20 or whatever the case, or Pathfinder or whatever. You pick all that stuff under playing, and then you select when your next game will be, including the date and the time. You pick how many players you need, and then you pick your game type, whether it's role-playing, card game, board game, whatever. You select how often you do it in frequency. Of course, this is weekly. You select whether it's video and voice. The primary language is English, of course. And then you can select. There's a checkbox. New players are welcome. You want to pick that so it'll help them to find, your group, because there is a, I'll show you later here in just a second. Anyways, okay, take a look at this one. Here's on the bottom of that same area. There's a option for mature content. If you talk about things that you don't want to talk about in front of your kids, you check marks that. And then, of course, right underneath it is a description. You can type in all that, whatever you want to say. This is a Pathfinder group for adults over the age of whatever. This, that, the other thing, blah, blah, blah. You type all that stuff in there. And then at the very, very bottom, there's a line that says listing discussion. It says there's a blue button in the lower left-hand corner for posting a new topic. You want to post the topic right away. And I put join. You can be a little bit more user-friendly than that. You can click in here to join or whatever. And that's where they would click to go in there and state their case, why they want to join your group. And then, and then of course, you'll get a private message. It'll tell you that somebody wants to join your group. And then this is what happens. And, okay, so I'll show you all that in just a second here. So anyways, when you set all that up, this is what happens. If you click on that thing there in the middle there, it'll zoom in. I have it circled in red. There's a function that says find a group. Okay? And then so you click that to find a group, right? And after you click that, then you'll see this. And if you click that image, it'll zoom in there, and you can see here. Here's where you can type in what you're looking for. This is in the Find Games joint. You can type in the left-hand side, I want to play whatever, Pathfinder. You type in Pathfinder, it'll come up. In this case, I used a keyword. I just typed in my own name. And then I hit the Find Games button. There's a blue button there. You got to click that button, otherwise it'll never come up. So click the blue button. It'll work. Boop, and then all the stuff will show up. So here you can see the group that I just created, and it's all in there. It says when we play or when we get together, which is just nonstop. It says a little bit about the group, which I showed you where you type all that in. It shows me, and all that good stuff. Okay, so that's how other people will find you, okay? And so when they when you put a posting in your thing and people say, hey, I want to join the group, this is what shows up. You'll get listings in there. People post in there like a forum. Hey, I want to join the group, okay? And you'll see right next to their name there's a blue button that says invite to the game. So you click that one, it'll say invitation sent. If you need to add something or type something to these folks, you can type it in the bottom and then submit your post. It'll put it in there. Like, hey, don't forget to say, you know, when you're available or whatever. You can give them some more information there. Okay? And then let's see here. Did I show you this one? No, I don't think I showed you this one. Okay. So anyways, when you find a group, or when the player finds a group, when they find your group and you accept them, then this is what they see. When they click on the games tab at the top, a drop down shows up and it'll show all the games that they have been invited to. Okay, to join the game, they click the little at the very bottom. You see under each one of those games, you'll see it says join game. You just click that one and it'll take them right into the game, right? Okay, now that is the link for your game, and you can get it in other spots. You can get it here. If you click on that image, it'll zoom it in. It'll show you. I circled it in red. You can get that same link that you can email to people in the invite players button, which you can see in the background of that. It's in purple. On the right-hand side underneath the DM for Hire stuff, you'll see a big, big purple button. When you click that, this window pops up. You can type in an email address and send it to them. It'll tell you what invites are pending, and then at the very bottom that I have circled in red, that's you can highlight that, you can copy it, you can paste it and put it in an email, send it to your buddies and tell them that you're hosting a game, and that's how they get into the game once they're invited. The other place that exact same link is located is actually in the game. So if you go into your game, where I showed you earlier, like when you join the game, the first time it loads up, it'll put like a gray box on the right-hand side. But when you hover your mouse over that gray box, this is what you see. It says the player link for this campaign is, and then there's that exact same information that I just showed you over there. So that's how you find it. Okay. So either way, you can get it either way. Okay, so now, when you invite someone to your group, this is what you're going to see. You're going to see they're going to come into the main area where you put all your postings. Okay, now this is a new group I just started, the DM 101, and that's why we're having this little talk here. It was a free training class for Dungeon Masters that are starting up and how to get involved in Roll20. If you join this group that I just showed you, this is what I have present. These are some of the things I have in the forum already. They can click up, they can read it, they can copy, paste it. That's what I'm trying to make a group that's different from anything else, where you can come in here and you can download stuff. It's free stuff, like the DM action cards. You know, I do a lot of graphic arts work, so I put it up there so you can take advantage of that, save yourself some time. And there's other tips and tricks, and this class will, the transcription for it and everything that I'm showing you and telling you will be in here and posted in here. So if you forget something, if something doesn't make sense, whatever, the phone rings and you miss a section, whatever, don't worry. Join the group if you're not in it, and Everything that I'm saying right now will be in this forum, so you can come and you can check it out later. Okay. So let's take a look at a couple more handouts. Okay, so say, for instance, let me just go ahead and go to my script here. I do have a couple things on my script that I want to share with you. Okay, so actually, let me just hang on a second. Let me skip this handout really quick. I was going to go to, okay, so here now, look at this. You can look for players for your D&D group, okay? So you go into the games thing I just showed you, and instead of clicking a game that you're already a part of, on the left-hand side there was an area that said find a game. So you click that and it brings you to here. At the top, I typed in RPG, and this is what it came up, a basic fantasy RPG. I clicked find players, the blue button there, and it came up with a listing of people. I didn't show all of them, and I deleted pretty much all of their information. I deleted their icon and their name and all that stuff because I didn't ask them permission. So, but anyways, it comes up with a list. Okay, so what you do, now that you can see people that want to play the types of games that you want to play, what you can do is you can right-click over their name and open up their information. And this is what you'll see. You'll see something that looks just like this. Of course, like I said, I deleted their icon and their awards and achievements and stuff and their bio. So you take a look at them. Okay, this is what they're interested in playing in the bio. They've been here for this long. They're a GM of X number of games. Okay, and they want to play this type of game. Okay, so if this person appeals to you and you want them to be in your group, then you can click on the send private message I have circled in red there. Okay, so and then when you send them a private message, you can keep it short and sweet. I usually just say, have you found a group yet? Or like, have you found a whatever, a Pathfinder group? Have you found a D&D group? Whatever the case may be, just send them a quick thing. They'll usually reply back, yeah, I'm good, thanks, you know, and that's it. And then you can pursue somebody else. This is the legwork that a lot of people don't like to do, by having to go out and cold call people and find the players that they need to play in their group. They find it easier to join a group and then contact all the DM's players and then run off with their players and piss everybody off and cause a fucking mess. So we don't want to do that. Don't be an arch nemesis on Roll20. Find your own players. Do the legwork like I did to get all these great people in my group, and you'll get some people in your group, and you won't be hunted down like a wild animal. So okay, so anyways, that's that. You send them a private message, and you can get your messages this way. Of course, on the right hand side, when you click under your name, a drop down shows up, and you can click under where it says private messages, and it'll take you into an area where you can. You can see who replied, and you can talk to those people, and of course this is what you can see. You can see people who I've talked to and sent me things, and hey, I want to do this and I want to join, or I can't make it, or whatever the case may be. It'll be in your inbox, and you'll get a red envelope in the upper right hand corner with a number under it. I circled that in red. That shows you that you've got some people that there are messages. When you click that red envelope, a drop down shows up, and you can view it, or you can dismiss it. Nah, it doesn't apply to me. Maybe it's for some group that you're into, that you join, and you really have no interest in it, in whatever the message may be, so you just get rid of it. So okay, so that's that, right? And so
that you can move.
And so, okay, so you make a mistake, and you invited somebody. Somehow the player got your link, and now he's in your game, okay? And you're like, I don't want this guy here. Whatever the case may be, you can get rid of him. So this is what you do. You go into that particular group or campaign, and all the player icons will be shown on the right-hand side where it says players, okay? And if you right-click over any one of those icons for the offending player, you can do one of two things. You can promote them to GM, or you can kick them from the game. And so this guy doesn't belong here. Okay, you click on kick him from the game. Okay, now his icon will no longer be there. If he tries to log back into your game, he won't be able to log back into your game again. But now you got to remember that you have to notify all your players that are supposed to be in your game what the link is, because it will have changed. And you go to the places that I just showed you. Either go into the game, look under the gray box when you hover your mouse on, over it, or go in and invite your player and get it from there. And just private message it to all your players. You know, just right-click the ones that are in your group. Private message, hey, here's the new link, and just make sure that you use that from now on, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so that's how that works. And last but not least, I went ahead and I posted all of this up in the DM 101 form already. I'm not going to read it verbatim. You can copy and paste that to your heart's content. But I will just kind of go very quickly through my script. So when you put your listing up there, here's some things that you want to list. You want to list your game type, whether it's D&D Pathfinder, the game style, whether it's commercial or homebrew, the rule set, if it's version 1, version 2, blah, whatever, or whether or not you use house rules. You want to tell them how your group is set up, if it's chat only, if it's audio, if it's video, or any combination thereof. For audio, you want to specify whatever host program you're using, whether it's Skype or TeamSpeak, etc., etc. I do not recommend using the Roll20 audio system. It just creates computer issues. Your system will jam up, and it's a nightmare. Just use Roll20 to do Roll20 stuff. And then use something else. Have somebody else host the call. We don't use video because it needlessly uses up your internet. And if you're on a slow line, it just makes your gaming experience slow and laggy. And honestly, I don't feel like having to dial myself up just for what you get out of it. It's basically pointless. First thing, instruct your players to change your settings to no audio and no video and names only. That way you can actually see the game that you want to watch, and you don't have to look at my ugly mug hogging up the whole damn screen. So get rid of it. It's not worth it. And if you try to watch other groups, you'll notice yourself being like totally distracted with videos, looking at Dave so-and-so as he's picking his nose or whatever. So just shut it off. It's just not worth it. You want to put also your age group, whether it's adult or whatever the case may be, whether or not you accept newbies. I don't do newbies right now. I don't have time for it right now. But and that you take breaks. You want to make sure that you put that in there. We say every 2 hours, give or take. Recently, though, I think we've been caught up in the fantasy realm enough to forget, but we try to schedule that each session. So there are at least 2 breaks in a 6 to 8 hour session. So that's enough time to get up, stretch your legs, go to the restroom, whatnot. And, of course, there are other ways to find players for your group. When you search for groups, scroll down and look at how many people are in each group. And when you see a group that has a substantial amount of people, like, say, over 20, chances are that it's a hangout where people go to find places to play. So what you do is you join that group, then you post in that area what you're looking for, and then, of course, you field your private message responses as you normally would. And the post might be like new 5e group looking for players, or established 2e group needs thief, etc. So that's another way you can find players. In fact, I'll cold call and talk to people in those types of groups all the time. Hey, you know, I understand you enjoy playing this. We have an open seat. We're looking for this. Blah blah blah. You know, why don't you come check it out? Anyways, but there is a vetting process. You don't willy-nilly send the invites and then it's a done deal. So send them a form letter and address it to them in a personal way. Hey, Joe Blow, here's the invite. We want to evaluate you. And so you explain to them that they understand that they are a potential player, but other people will be trying out for the same seat, and that the group will eventually decide who is going to be asked to stay. So this is not an invitation to the group, done deal. You're under evaluation. And I always point out that attendance is key in a determining factor, since other players are counting on this person to be there each and every session. And if you stream your sessions, that's even a bonus, because you can give potential new players the opportunity to watch you and your group before you send out the invite link. So you just tell them, hey, we play every Saturday at 6 o'clock, and here's Twitch.tv/DM for hire. Check us out. And if you're interested, then get back to me, and we can talk about it and get your thoughts and opinions. And then you can take it from there, and then you can send out an invite link, okay? And so this way they know what they're getting into beforehand, and there aren't any surprises. They'll know if it's a good fit or not. I prefer to have people to have some degree of character and sense of humor, even if that means at least me getting a chuckle out of them at some point. They don't necessarily have to be a constant source of gags or one-liners, but I'm not a big fan of bumps on logs, where they make for boring gameplay. And watch other groups online, and you'll see exactly what I'm talking about. They're so straight-laced. I feel like intentionally, trolling their chat room while they're streaming live, just to try and break the ice. It's really annoying. But anyways, in this transcription that I'll put up in the DM101 forum, I put a welcome letter. You can tweak that to your heart's content. And you'll notice in the welcome letter that I reference in-game handouts for them to read. I encourage you to make the Roll20 startup experience as painless as possible and put everything they need in-game so that it's not a requirement that they have to have any materials whatsoever. Because if you find out, if you buy anything from Wizards of the Coast, you'll find out that the stuff has zero longevity. We're still using stuff from like 30 years ago that holds up great. I've heard horror stories of people already on their second 5th edition Player's Handbook and Monster Manual, and that's just ridiculous. So just so you know, be forewarned. And just kind of help them out, so that they know where they have to go. And, of course, be sure that you give them a character sheet, because if they go in there to start a character and there's no character sheet, they're basically foobard. So, and last but not least, closure. Always be professional about it, and be sure to notify everyone that applied. Thank them and tell them that you appreciate them actually taking time to be considered for the open seat, but the group decided to select another player. That way they're not wondering whether they are in the process or where they are in the process, and they can apply for some other group opening somewhere else. And as for the one you select, congratulate them on a job well done. And that's pretty much the entire process of finding players and so forth. But anyways, let's do what we love.